In this video, we are going to discuss the boundary layer, and in that one, we will discuss the displacement thickness, momentum thickness, and energy thickness. For this, consider here one plate of dimension L by V, and U infinity is the free stream velocity. Left hand side indicates a three dimensional figure, and this one is two dimensional figure. In two dimensional, you can't see the width B, but you can very well see the length L. Let's consider here one plane perpendicular to the plane of the plate. Therefore, you can find here the height H is there. So, this area is perpendicular to the velocity. So, mass flow rate through this plate is given by rho into b into h multiplied by u infinity, where b is the width, h is the height, is the area, u infinity is the perpendicular to it, that is discharge. Now, let's consider here a boundary layer. When we keep a plate over the in this flow, we have a boundary layer development. In the boundary layer development, we will find here the velocity at the wall is zero. It go on increasing, and afterwards it becomes u infinity. The maximum value enclosed is 0.99 of u infinity, and the boundary layer. So let's say this height is equals to h minus u infinity, h minus delta. We have the mass flow rate from the top section that you can see. The top section has the uniform height, the uniform width of B, and height is equal to h minus delta. So m dot is rho into h minus delta multiplied by B multiplied by u infinity. The question is that how we are going to calculate the mass flow rate variable velocity section. So for this one, we'll consider here one element thickness dy at distance y from the wall. So and to this area, we have a velocity equals to u, which is a function of y and delta. So we have to calculate this one by integration method. So area at this section is b multiplied by dy. So we'll multiply by rho also to find out the discharge, and local velocity is equals to u. So if you find out this quantity, you will get a mass flow rate after the insertion of plate, whereas a mass without plate is equals to rho into b into h into u infinity. Let's say that we will consider only the delta portion of this one. So if I consider delta portion, in that case the mass flow rate will be equal to rho into b multiplied by delta multiplied by u infinity. And naturally here the vertical column will vanish in that case, and you are only left with the bottom column. So we have here this quantity will become zero, and we are left with zero to delta rho times b into dy multiplied by u. So this time we are comparing the mass only for delta height. So naturally the mass on the left hand side is more than the right hand side. Because of insertion of plate, there is a loss of mass, and this mass of loss is get compensated by a certain height of a boundary layer that is called as displacement thickness. So loss of mass is m dot minus m dot 1, and to adjust this mass we have to displace the boundary layer by a certain thickness that is called as displacement thickness, is normally represented by del asterisk. So del asterisk, now this thickness is outside the boundary layer, so it has a constant velocity equal to u infinity. And if you see the cross section of this one, cross section is delta x multiplied by b, streak multiplied by b multiplied by u infinity. So our mass flow rate is rho into delta asterisk b into the thickness of the flow measured for perpendicular to the stream. You have to measure this thickness perpendicular to the direction of flow. Free stream velocity equal to infinity, and having the flow rate equal to the loss in mass rate on account of boundary layer formation. So we have to find out the loss of mass, that with and without the plate. So without plate we have m dot, and with plate we have m dot 1. This mass loss of mass is get adjusted due to displacement thickness, that is equals to the constant area. Here this area is del asterisk multiplied by b multiplied by u infinity multiplied by rho. So let's solve this equation here for del asterisk. So del asterisk rho into del asterisk into b into u infinity is equals to m dot minus m dot 1. M dot is rho into b into delta into u infinity, and m dot 1 is 0 to delta rho into b into dy into u. So in this case you find here that the rho is constant term, and even the b is also constant term, so that will be get cancelled. So rho will be cancelled. Now you left with here on the left hand side is del asterisk by u infinity, on the right hand side we have del into u infinity, on the right hand side we have 0 to delta u into dy. Now what we do is that we'll divide it by u infinity, so we'll get del asterisk equals to del minus 0 to delta u upon u infinity into dy. Now we'll make a slight trick here. We can replace this del y by integration of dy from 0 to delta. So del asterisk is equals to, instead of del I will write integral dy from 0 to delta. Integral dy is y, and upper limit is delta and lower limit is 0. So we get the same answer, minus integral 0 to delta u upon u infinity into dy. Now why we have done this? Because we have two integrals having the same limit and same variable. We can write combine them, and del asterisk equal to 0 to delta, it should be delta 1 minus u upon u infinity into dy. So this is the expression for displacement thickness. Remember, delta is not there, it is delta. So remember this equation, this is how you can find out displacement thickness. Now similar to the displacement thickness, we can define the momentum thickness. In displacement thickness, we have a loss of mass, and in momentum thickness, we have a loss of momentum. So it is represented by theta and is defined as the thickness of the flow moving at a free stream velocity, having momentum flux equal to deficiency, that is the loss of momentum flux in the region of boundary layer. So what we do is that we have to do the entire exercise by taking the momentum balance, and then you have to solve for theta. So I will skip that and I will give the direct relation for this one. So theta is defined as integral 0 to delta u upon u infinity. Here we can say that is a tentative term representing the velocity, and we know the loss of mass is 1 minus u upon u infinity. So we have mass into velocity will equals to momentum. That is how you can remember this. So theta is defined as 0 to delta u upon u infinity 1 minus u upon u infinity into dy. Now similar to moment, if there is a loss of mass, there is a loss of energy. Therefore we have to define one more term, that is called as energy thickness, that is represented by del del double asterisk. This time also I will give the direct relation because proof is very lengthy. Del double asterisk is equals to integral 0 to delta, is almost same definition, and there is a loss of what? Energy this time only. U upon u infinity 1 minus u square upon u infinity square. You can have this like this, that is a 1 by 2 into mass into velocity square. Remember the equation of displacement thickness, momentum thickness and energy thickness. Now we'll take the numerical based on these two problems to get your concept clear. So we have del asterisk equal to 0 to delta 1 minus u upon u infinity, theta equals to 0 to delta u upon u infinity 1 minus u by u infinity, and del double asterisk, that is energy thickness, is 0 to delta u upon u infinity 1 minus u square upon u infinity square into dy. First question in 2017, we have given the velocity profile as u upon u infinity sine of 2 delta. We want to calculate delta asterisk is the local displacement thickness, and we want to calculate del asterisk by del delta. In this case, we are given the velocity profile u upon u infinity equal to sine of pi by pi into y by 2 delta. So we'll use the definition of displacement thickness here. If I use the definition del asterisk equal to 0 delta 1 minus u upon u infinity to dy, so let's replace here u by infinity equal to this value. So integral of 1 is y, integral of sine is minus of cos, minus minus will become plus, so this will become plus cos of pi y divided by 2 delta, and this is a composite function, so we have to again divide it by the derivative of pi y divided by 2 delta, that is will be the derivative of this term is pi divided by 2 delta, and we have upper limit and lower limit, that is so we substituted for y, so we have y equal to 0 and y is equal to delta. Let's put the upper limit and try to solve this. Get del asterisk equals to limit for y is delta and lower limit is 0. We adjust the denominator in numerator, 2 delta divided by pi, and now we have substitute for delta. If I substitute for delta, then I will get cos of only pi by 2 delta, that will be my delta will be cancelled and I will get only pi by 2, and second term is minus term, so that will be cos of 0. So we left with delta plus 2 delta, then minus 2 times delta divided by pi. Delta can be taken common, so delta to 1 minus 2 by pi. Your delta asterisk delta equal to 1 minus 2 pi. So this is a very simple solution. You have to just do one integration and we can get your answer. This is second numerical, it appeared in 1992. We have different velocity distribution and we want to calculate displacement thickness. Rest parameters are same. Let's define the definition. Let's use the definition first, and directly we'll substitute for u upon infinity. We have del asterisk equal to 0 delta 1 minus u upon infinity is minus of 3 by 3 into y by delta minus of 2 into y by delta whole square. And now this term is ready for integration. Integration of y is with respect to dy is y. Second term we have minus of 3. Delta is a constant term, can be taken outside. Integral of y is y square by 2. Minus and minus will become plus term. So 2 divided by delta square can be taken common because that is a constant term. Integral of y square is cube by 3. And now we'll put for limit from 0 to delta. Lower limit is 0 is meaningless. So we'll only solve for upper limit. We are left with delta. Minus 3 by 2, del square is delta and divided by delta, we left with only one delta, 2 by 3. Now delta cube divided by delta square, that is equal to delta. Remember, in all velocity profile, we'll only get delta term. And solve this, delta take we can take common. Left with 1 minus 3 by 2 plus 2 by 3. Let's take the LCM here, this will be 6, so this will be 6 minus 9 plus 4 by 6, sorry, is delta by 6. Now in this case, we are given the velocity profile as y by delta, and we want to calculate the ratio of displacement thickness to momentum thickness. So in this case we have to calculate both the displacement as well as momentum thickness. We want to calculate ratio of displacement thickness is elastic divided by theta. We have the first two definition you have to use in this one. We have elastic equals to 1 minus and u by u infinity will replace as y by delta. So this is a very straightforward integration. So let integral here 1 with respect to y, that will be y minus 1 by delta is common. Integration of y is y square by 2, 0 to delta. So this will be delta minus 1 by delta. This will be delta square by 2. So you will get 1 by 2 delta. So delta minus delta by 2. So you will get delta by 2. Let's try for momentum thickness. In case of momentum thickness, we have integral 0 to delta. U upon u infinity is y by delta into bracket 1 minus u by infinity is y by delta. In this case, we will first expand the bracket, then we will integrate it. So we have integral 0 to delta. Term is y by delta. The second term is y square by delta square. Integration of y, delta can be taken common first. Integration of y is del y square by 2. Minus 1 by delta square can be taken common. Integration of y square is y cube by 3. Limits from 0 to delta. The lower limit is meaningless, so we only calculate for upper limit, that is delta. This is delta and this is delta square, so it is left as delta by 2 as common, and this is delta cube by delta square, again delta. Every time we will get delta, that is sure. So this answer is delta by 6. Finally, we need to calculate the ratio of displacement thickness to momentum thickness. We have del asterisk divided by theta. Let's put this as delta by 2 divided by delta by 6. This ratio come out to be 3.